Hey everybody, this is Nick. Today we're going to talk about adding individual goal or benchmark lines to your column chart. So these are kind of like indicators or markers that will just show some sort of aggregated value that you want to compare another value to, like these columns here. So these would be like monthly averages for individual months and those satisfaction scores, and you can see which months are sort of performing below and above the monthly average in that case. Now in the last video we did a single trend line across the entire chart, so I'll link above and below for that, but this case we're going to use individual lines, and we have to do this just a little bit differently, and there's a little bit of a trick. There's another trick if you want to get a little bit more custom at the end, so stay tuned to the end to watch that. So just like we did before, this chart is going to start from a clustered bar chart. These are our columns, or column chart. These are our columns of data right here, and these will be the lines or the benchmark thresholds that we want to place into the chart. Now, if I right-click and say Edit Data, we're going to see the data. This is how that data is set up. You can just see two columns of data, the data column, the average column, and then you're going to select that all. You're going to create a clustered column just like this. It's going to look like this. You're going to format it to taste all of the good stuff that you want to do. Now we're going to select this chart, and now what I'm going to do is we're going to go back to the chart design tab, click on change chart type, and let's go back down to that combo chart option right here. It already gives us the data in a clustered column just like we like, and now it's saying average. It's giving us a line chart. Now instead of line, I'm going to make it a little bit easier for us. I'm just going to switch it to line with a marker, and I'm going to say okay, and now you can see we're starting to get each of those individual markers. But what we need to do is click on that and then get rid of the line. So go to the Format Data Series menu, under line, we're going to say no line. And now you can see we have our little individual markers. Now we want to make them much bigger. If you wanted them to stay as circles, you can go ahead and just click the built-in option there, circle, and then go ahead and increase that just like you would do there. But you can see from this type option, you get many different options. You could do squares. You could do this little diagonal there, rectangle. You could do the triangle. You could do just like an X. I wouldn't really recommend those. Here's really where the line is. But the problem with this is if you continue to increase it, it just gets bigger and bigger. And I kind of want a treatment where the line is pretty thin, but it's also wide enough to sort of span the entire, just be a little bit longer in terms of the width of each of these columns. So another little option that I might do, I'm going to go ahead and duplicate this slide, is create a custom marker with a shape. So let's go to insert. I'm going to go ahead and insert this shape, and actually let's do a rectangle with rounded corners. I'm going to go ahead and just put it over here on my slide, and I'm going to make this a different color just so that we can see this in action here. I'm going to say that orange, and then we're going to have as a line, I'm going to say a white outline, and what we're going to do is I'm just going to go ahead and pull the rounded corners so that they're completely rounded there. And now what I'm going to do is I'm going to make this really, really narrow. So we're going to go ahead and say height, it's right there to 0.29. If I go down to 1, and let's maybe actually do 0.05. It makes it even more narrow. And then I'm going to say under width, let's just make this, I'm going to kind of drag this down here just to see how long I want this. Maybe one more titch down. I'm going to tick down one more tick right there. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to push Control C to copy this shape. And inside of my markers and my marker options, we'll click on those markers again, paint bucket, marker options right here, go down to that marker options menu. And then instead of the built-in, I'm going to say picture. So go all the way down here, picture. And right now it's asking from a file. I don't want to do that. So what we're going to do is we're going to do this the brute force way first. We're going to say Control C to copy this. I'm going to go ahead and click on my markers and Control V to paste. So I don't have to save that shape as an image. Now you can see here, it's a little, now once we click on this, we're going to go back to that marker options. And you can see right now it's already then set there to the picture. Now the problem here is maybe this picture is a little bit too long. Now you can see maybe there's a little bit of overlap. So if I want it to be a little bit shorter, I'm just going to go back and I'm going to change my custom shape. So instead of 0.9, let's go to 0.8, maybe 0.7, Control C, and now I'm going to go ahead and Control V to paste the custom marker in again. Now I like that much better. If I wanted to go ahead and put a label on here, I'm going to singly isolate this one, and then say add data label right there. Let's go ahead, and if I wanted to put it onto the side, we could do that. I'm going to change the name. Instead of the value, I'm going to say series, and it's going to say average. And we'll go ahead and just format that to sort of taste right there. I don't necessarily want to add the value in here because each of these values are different. So if I wanted that to be thicker, I could go ahead up to my shape format menu, my custom shape again. Let's make this a little bit wider. Control C. And I'm going to go Control V to paste. And there we have our custom average lines. If I wanted to get rid of that white line, then I would have to update that in my source. Oops, I would have to update that in my my custom shape here. So I'm going to go ahead and make that. And then the outline, I'm going to say no outline. And maybe just make it a little bit skinnier again. Control C and Control V. And now you have some nice custom average lines to your bars. So that's kind of just a nice little workaround, I think, to get those markers to be a little bit more custom to the look and feel that you want. So I hope you like this video. If you do, give it a thumbs up and hit the subscribe button and the bell next to it. You'll get notified every time I post a new video in data design, usually PowerPoint, Excel, or Word. Had a great time making this for you. Can't wait to see you next time.